I listen to.
Yeah. And Terry said, that's why everyone's got to like and share this one to get it going bigger. Yeah, 100%. That's right. Everybody boy, share this Terry. Thing out.
Appreciate
Tell
that.
Tell your friends. Tell your friends. We always appreciate that. Let's dive off of that topic. Let's move into NFL news. I don't know really that it's news per se, but NFL stars want league changes. They released the Strong Together video last night. Now, did you get to see this video?
Saw the video. Thought it was very well done.
I thought it was as well. Title on CNN says, or headline on CNN, NFL players release video calling on the league to condemn racism and support black players. Now, we'll say this. I got an email from Kroger and from Target today condemning racism.
I'm so tired and of the companies that are just telling me that they don't like racism.
Yeah, I don't feel like the NFL, you know, but your players are wanting you to do it, so you probably need to do it.
Well, no, the players, they want somebody to step up and actually do things for their communities. I believe that. I think they're wanting action more than anything else.
Yeah, I agree. Let me read through some of the article here. It calls on the league to condemn racism and support black players. Houston Texans quarterback Deshaun Watson was joined in the video by other football stars, including Odell Beckham Jr., Patrick Mahomes, Michael Thomas, DeAndre Hopkins, Tyrann Mathieu, Ezekiel Elliott, and Saquon Barkley. That's big time names.
That's some stars.
In the video, it says, how many times do we need to ask you to listen to your players? What will it take for one of us to be murdered by police brutally by police brutality? It said, so on behalf of the NFL, this is what we, the players, would like to hear you state. We, the National Football League, condemn racism and the systematic oppression of black people. We, the National Football League, admit wrong in silencing our players from peacefully protesting. We, the National Football League, believe Black Lives Matter. The thing that stood out to me in this statement was, we, the National Football League, admit wrong in silencing our players from peacefully protesting. This is going to get really interesting. And I wonder if, because it's somewhat the safe thing to do now, because every company is coming out and doing this, etc., I wonder what the backlash will be from fans this time if there is kneeling, if there is protesting and whatnot on the field, and whether or not the owners are going to be okay with it. Because obviously it became a big-time issue last time because there was, you know, viewership declines, etc. This time...
Hang on, and what happened to those viewership declines?
Well, I mean, once everything stopped, once Kaepernick was out of the league, they went back up 20%.
No, so, Kaepernick was never in the league. He wasn't even in the league.
He wasn't after that.
Cap
first
didn't
year.
Have anything to do with it. I'm but telling every, you, the product was rough. There was the election was going on, and it was the craziest election we've ever had in our life.
Agreed. Like, and the next year there was still the decline because there was still all of the political tension that was going on.
We disagree on that.
Look, we can disagree if you want to, but the facts of the matter are there were still players that were kneeling, and it was still a major league story going on that year. And
it was
and
a
that
story.
Doesn't necessarily mean that that was exactly what it was. But
everybody the I know that protests at the NFL don't watch the NFL anyway, and they haven't their entire lives.
Look, all I'm saying is once
but they
the stories,
sure came out and told everybody they don't watch it now.
Once the stories stopped, viewership ratings went back up 20%. That's all I'm saying. So if you can say it's mitigating circumstances, whatever, and I don't know that that was necessarily what it was, but who knows, right? Who knows? Let me jump into the chat just started going bananas. Let's see. Ben said, for example, the CBS Cover 3 podcast gives you all the details for any college football news they know anything about, and it's free. Yeah, 100%. Podcasts are great. Damien said, I don't see why anyone has to get laid off just to save money for their company when they can put everyone in furlough and make pay cuts. Well, here's the thing. They've had guys furloughed for a long time, but now the company is, you know, not making as much money.
You can't
make
furlough them forever.
Yeah, I mean, it's tough. Terry said, you have to know where you're buying stuff from. Have a heart. That's why Subaru is made with love. I'd rather it be made with precision and attention to detail.
Hey, now, Subaru is made with precision to detail. They just quit advertising that, and they started putting puppies on there, okay, because that's what the marketing people say. But Listen, you're talking to a two-time Subaru owner, all right? That's what I put my family in because I'm pretentious as hell, and I love them more than you love yours.
There you go.
The only thing I know about Subarus are is if you put your family in a Subaru, you love your family more than other people love theirs. That's what I was told. That's what I believe. That's why I bought.
Ben just jumped in and said Subaru for life. There you go. Emperor Bam. Of Rome said, who gives a crap about what the company's opinions are?
I don't understand, okay?
I feel like everybody should be against racism. I don't know that you have to make a statement. It's kind of like everybody's against...
We're all for clean air, right?
Yeah, we don't want anybody to have cancer. Like,
no, that's right.
I don't feel like I have to make a statement.
That's right. I always found it weird that we had, like, a cancer awareness month. And I guess we have breast cancer awareness month, and we're, like, going after a very specific thing. Yeah. And I'm not against that. But, like... is anybody not for this? Do we need a month for it? Because we're all okay with breast cancer and all cancers never being around, right?
Yeah, we're totally fine with that.
I just found that.
It's a simple thing. It's a very simple thing.
Very simple thing.
Damien said, NFL is just kissing ass because of what Fangio said about the NFL not being racist. That's all they're doing.
There's no doubt. That's 100%. These players are trying to get something different.
Yeah, but the NFL hasn't done anything yet.
So here's what I wonder, okay? I want to know how this plays out. So let's say the NFL, the commissioner, and all the owners say, you know what, guys? You're right. We will acknowledge all of these things, okay? And we're going to begin to start to donate money and resources, which I'm still trying to figure out. How do you donate money to fight racism? At some point in time, we got to educate. I do believe this. We're going to have to stop yelling and shouting at one another, and you got to find a way to talk to people.
Agreed.
Because that's the only way you're really going to... Now, if you want to yell at them because you're mad, that's fine. I yell at people all the time. But I know when I'm yelling at them, I'm not ever going to change their mind. There's a comedian, you and I talked about him before. God, I forget his name every time. He's a black comedian. He started befriending like KKK guys and neo-Nazi guys. And he started catching a whole lot of hell for it. And he's literally turned like 20 or 30 of these guys from their ways. And now those guys are all like, yes, I realize I was wrong. I was raised this way. And now I know I've been educated. And I don't do that. And if he just gave them the middle finger and punched a Nazi, those five guys would still be, or 20 guys or whoever it is, would still be fighting the other fight against them. And now they're fighters for good. And I don't know how to have this conversation. No, I don't know what needs to be said.
Was it Donnell Rawlings? Was it Donnell Rawlings?
That sounds more
familiar. Was it somebody that was on Rogan?
But I also know Donnell. So I might be remembering him just because I know him and I know his stuff.
Yeah. So the main premise behind this is I believe that at this point, because it is... because it's safe, because I feel like viewers are not going to turn out because of this, because everybody finally seems to be coming around to the idea that, yes, it has been a problem. You were talking about, by the way, what you can do to donate, all that kind of stuff. I believe it's blacklivesmatter.org has got a ton of different charities, a ton of places.
Good. That's where I need to go. Then I need to look at that then.
So, yeah, my wife has been kind of looking it up, trying to be a part of the solution, et cetera.
Well, I mean, I follow Patriot stuff, okay? So I saw Robert Kraft came out and donated $1 million to fight racism. And I love Robert, okay? I think he's the greatest owner in the world. I defend him endlessly for most everything. And I thought, how's money going to fix this problem? Like, and then I begin to think of, now I know how money could help fix this problem. We could pay for a lot of attorney fees for a lot of people who are wrongfully imprisoned but all my issues that I think of are all criminal reform, because that's a world I know.
Yeah.
Okay. I was a criminal justice major when I went through college, and I follow that stuff. I see the flaws in it and the struggles of it so badly but I was trying to think of right now, other than that world that I know specifically, that can't be all there is. What else can money do?
Yeah.
Because at some point in time, we got to change people's hearts. And I don't know how to do that with money.
Oh, it's almost impossible. But, I mean, obviously you can byproducts from black-owned businesses, you know, et cetera, et cetera.
Okay,
et cetera.
All right. Yeah. All that so we can begin to support that. And that's and that's fine. Those are just things that I was trying to figure out. Bob Kraft is dropping $1 million. That's amazing. What's the $1 million for? And what is it going with it? Because I don't want it.
Like, is it just going to protesters, or is it like, you know, it's that kind of thing?
I want it to actually go to help people, because I'm instantly thinking of, you know, attorneys I know that struggle to do pro bono work for, you know, these black men is the majority of 90% of what they deal with that they believe are wrongfully, you know, incarcerated because they just couldn't afford a good attorney.
Yeah, this
but that
this,
stuff costs a lot of money, and it takes a lot of time. And these guys are doing it on the super cheap, and it still costs crazy amounts of money.
This situation is different. Like, this kind of charity is different than something as simple as like donating to St. Jude. At St. Jude, you know exactly what it's going to. With this,
that's,
it's like,
I guess that's it. I know there's no real what LaBonner's going to. I know what St. Jude's going to. I know when I go to Susan B. Anthony, like, I'm fighting breast cancer.
Right. This one is not as easy to figure out, but that's why they do have the websites. There is the information out there. Jump into the chat here. Jose said, Roger Goodell thinks he's bigger than God. He's not. NBA Adam Silver. They were still kneeling. Then Trump said something to Jerry Jones. No, that is actually factually incorrect, because the NBA under David Stern set up this whole thing where you had to stand up and salute for the anthem. Otherwise, you were fined and you were suspended. And that is still in play. So David Stern set all that kind of stuff up. And that was, what was the guy's name? His name was Chris Jackson at LSU. And then Chris Abdul something or other. He was the one that was sitting out for the national. He wasn't kneeling. Yeah. He was just sitting on the bench. And
that's right.
Yeah, he got suspended for games. It became a big issue.
I would tell you what's interesting, the way the NBA does it, if you sat on the bench, nobody would ever know, because every NBA arena I have ever been to,
it's dark,
blacks out almost the entire place except for the center court where you see the line of players, coaches, referees, and everything else. And so if somebody wasn't there, literally it would have to be like LeBron or Anthony Davis, like somebody who is big and visible and everybody knows what they look like.
To be fair,
to say, oh, are they not here?
Like when he was on the Nuggets, I mean, he was pretty big. Like it's because he was such a big name that it caused such a stir. So Ben said it's to get donations. Terry said they had puppies at the Detroit Auto Show last year. Didn't even bring all their cars, just puppies. It was nuts. Jose said the word is listening. Yeah, 100%. Terry said that's the truth. Whatever happened to being able to disagree with each other and still be friendly and have conversations? Social media happened. Like that's what it is.
Yes.
We used to be 100%. Able to disagree and have conversations, and people could actually grow without being canceled and everything else, right? So, you know.
So, I mean, if you listen to Yahoo's college football or college sports podcast now, like, you know me and you, I mean, I worship at the feet of Dan Wetzel, okay? Yeah. And, like, they kind of addressed a lot of this stuff, and he brought up, there's a guy that I love, okay? There's a guy that I have defended most of my life. It's Greg Popovich. I worship at the feet of Greg Popovich, okay? Love that man. But, like, when he goes on these shows and on social media and just blast Trump, like,
he loses me when he does that.
I appreciate it. You're not helping the cause, because the people who already agree with you, they already agree with you, and the people that don't are never going to respond well to that, because you're just yelling at them and telling them they're idiots. And at some point, you've got to get them on a human level if you want to change their mind.
Correct. Ben on Twitch said, I want to know exactly where the money will go before I donate. I think that's most people, and that's why the information
is out. Oh, I completely agree.
So, again, from what I understand, blacklivesmatter.org has got
There's a list of specific charities. Those charities have to tell you what they're doing with the money.
Yes.
So you're not giving it to one big group and they're funneling it to all these little groups. I think you would have to make actually donations to the specific thing.
You're right. And then finally, Damian said, I'm happy to see the stars and players fighting for our rights. It's just sad that it had to take Kaepernick kneeling to finally do something about it. I don't know that it was necessarily Kaepernick kneeling. I think like that was a small part of this entire thing. This has been going on in this country forever. It's been a problem forever. I mean, you had slavery end, and then 100 years later, you still had the Civil Rights Movement, and now we're 60 years past the Civil Rights Movement. This has been happening for a long time, and it's been a problem.
But Cap brought the – I would agree with Damien on this. Cap brought the attention at a level in which nobody knew, because nobody draws eyeballs like the NFL.
That's true.
And he put it on the biggest platform in the world outside of World Cup soccer.
Okay. That's true.
Give them their due. They're the biggest in the world, but definitely the biggest in the country.
Oh, yes.
He brought that attention. He's got to get that credit.
Now you got so that.
Regardless
right.
of what you think of him, regardless of all the flaws that he has, we've gone over those before. He did bring it to the attention, which is also why it became the
story, I guess, that it was.
The lightning rod that it became.
Oh, 100%. Ben said we need to have real town halls again. I believe that. I mean, 100%. Now, they do have town halls. It's just, you know, you've got 2 minutes to speak. It's not, you know, what can you really say in 2 minutes, right? It's just, it's tough. It's tough stuff.
No, you could say a lot in 2 minutes. Two minutes is longer than you think.
I mean, you have
to be organized in your thoughts. You have to know what you're going to say. You got to have a point.
Yes.
100%. But 2 minutes is a lot longer. Listen, for a guy who's trying to put together 5 minutes of something, 2 minutes is longer than you think.
Now you got